We have three groups of students helping us today. They are the Boy Scout Troop 200, Venture Crew 11, and the Order of the Arrow. So without any further ado, we'll get tuned up and we'll begin the concert. Thank you so much.
Thank you so very much, and welcome to our annual Young People's, Young Persons, Children's, Old Folks, everyone in between concert. We are the Cobb and Symphony. We're in our 18th season. We're pleased to be here to perform for you. This concert's a little different from the other ones. It's intended to help navigate sometimes a novice learner through the world of music, or the world of band, or the world of concert band, through the eyes of a child as we never grow up. That was James Curnow's Fanfare and Flourishes, lovely fanfare, which was one of the earliest functions of the ceremonial brass, the trumpets and the trombones, so they opened the concert with the fanfare. The next selection reminds us all of the function of the instruments and how they can be used through the centuries to create sounds of interest. So it's Peter and the Wolf. We have a wonderful narrator that's going to come out and talk all of us through Peter and the Wolf, and how the instruments have historically been used to create certain sounds. We hope you enjoy the story. introduce our narrator properly. Our narrator is John Spies. Please welcome to the board.
This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. One of the really fun things about this story is that all the characters are played by different instruments. The flighty bird is played by the high flute. The proud duck by the gorgeous oboe. The creeping cat by the sleek and rich clarinet. Old grandfather by the deep bassoon and low brass. The aggressive wolf by the powerful horns and saxophones. The hunter and his rifle shots by the timpani and bass drum. And our hero, Peter, by the entire ensemble. Now we're ready to begin. Now this story begins, like a lot of good stories, with Once Upon a Time. Once upon a time, there was a boy called Peter. He and his grandfather lived in a cottage with a garden surrounded by a high stone wall. And outside, there was a great meadow. And beyond the meadow, a deep, dark forest. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On the branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Soon, a proud duck came waddling around. She was delighted that Peter hadn't closed the gate, which meant that she could take a refreshing swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass and settled next to the duck and shrugged her shoulders. "What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" asked the bird. The duck replied, "Quack! What kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He spied a cat crawling through the grass. The cat figured, "The bird is arguing. I'll just grab her." Quietly, stealthily, she crept toward her on velvet paws. "Look out!" Peter shouted, and the bird instantly flew up into the tree, while the duck quacked angrily at the cat from the middle of the pond. Through the gate. Peter knew he wasn't supposed to go out into the meadow. "It's a dangerous place. What if a wolf came out of the forest? What then, eh?" Attention to his grandfather. Boys like Peter aren't afraid of wolves. But grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. No sooner had Peter and his grandfather left than a big gray wolf did come out of the forest. The cat scampered up the tree. The duck quacked and in her excitement jumped out of the pond. The wolf chased the duck. No matter how fast the duck tried to waddle away, she couldn't escape the wolf. He got closer and closer, and then with one gulp, swallowed her up.
Thank you.
this is where things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch of the big tree, the bird perched on another, not too close to the cat. While the wolf prowled round and round the tree, staring at them with greedy eyes. Meanwhile, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. Peter was a resourceful boy. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the stone wall. Now, one of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was prowling stretched out over the wall. So, reaching to grab hold of the branch, Peter swung over onto the tree. Peter whispered to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only be careful he doesn't catch you." The bird almost slapped the wolf's head with his wings. The wolf snapped angrily at him from this side and that. Oh, how the bird bothered that wolf. How the wolf wanted to catch her. But the bird was too clever, and the wolf just couldn't do a thing about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, caught the wolf by the tail and jerked with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf jumped about wildly, trying to get loose. But Peter had tied the other end of the rope to the tree, so the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his tail tighter. Just then, hunters came out of the woods, following the wolf's trail and shooting as they came. Peter, sitting in the tree, shouted, "Don't shoot! The bird and I have caught the wolf. Now just help us take him to the zoo." So now, just imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head, after him the hunters leading the wolf, and winding up the procession, Grandfather and the cat. Above them flew the bird, chirping merrily, "My, what brave fellows we are, Peter and I! Look what we have caught!" Thank you. listen very carefully, you can hear the duck quacking inside the wolf. Because in his haste, the wolf had swallowed her alive.
Thank you.